see. I think we could have been friends. Much clatter.
I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but we've no time for talk. Tolman was out here with me, and now Piety has him. They're headed for the crematorium. I've no chance against Piety and your blackguards, but you, you're another matter entirely. Please, you found it in your heart to rescue me. Tolman is just as worthy of... Too much clatter.
You have made peace with our land. For now, my spear is lowered. Travel far.
I am not surprised. I saw you, in my slumber, drive the darkness away. I am sorry that I did not tell you before. What I see is only what might happen, and I did not want to fill you with more confidence than would have been good for you. Be well.
Thank you for returning our reality to us. I think we've all had a glimpse of what could happen if Piety tries to harness the power of the Vaal for her own ends. Keep your life...
I knew this strangeness would pass. Silk does not run from such things. I stand, I guard, when others shiver and shake.
Make it fast. Return if you must.
What?
Going? Hello.
Humanity has one redeeming trait. We learn from our mistakes. You certainly gave us a scare for a bit there, but the damage doesn't seem to have been lasting. Thank you. Fare you well.
Mm-hmm.
Immortality is the mother of life. We have turned our backs on her.
Our paths meet in the shell of a long dead snail. An empire slow to see where its path was taking it. Built on the husk of another, and destined to be buried time and time again. This city will see great things yet, Exile. See you. Skittering across the ground, insects nest near unlikely allies.
A stranger walks into a town with a lost lover in tow. Sounds like the beginning of a jest, which I bloody wish it were. Problem is, we're still one doe-eyed lover short, which ain't much good to anyone. They tend to come in pairs, you see. Since you seem to be in the good deeds business, how about throwing a tollman into the bargain? Good luck to you. Come over here.
Madamua Patua thanks you, Exile, for returning our Clarissa to us. She is the gentle heart of this place, a spirit still capable of love in this wasteland of hatred. Yet that gentle heart remains in jeopardy. Tolman isn't deserving of Clarissa. Talakora.
Something? Watch yourself.
Come no closer, witch. The name's Grigor, and as you can see, I've had my fill of your kind. So once you've finished admiring your sisterhood's handiwork, turn those icy orbs of yours eastward. Yes, you've brought Clarissa home to us, and once again she pesters me with pity. There's only so much broth, so many bouquets that a man can take. For a criminal, Clarissa has... Have fun elsewhere.
The Monkey King has built his throne on your back. A throne of gold and gem, polished with blood and tear. Throw off the Monkey King and his shining privy before your back is broken.
Yeah.
deal with it. When you build something like this, you make persecution a way of life.
longer need fear. Destiny is seeing to that.
My work in progress. Let's see if Rayclast has been good to you, witch.
Thank you.
skittering across the ground. Insects nest near unlikely allies.
Too much clutter.
I miss a boy. He was always up for a laugh, whether it was at his expense or not. But I wouldn't miss that Clarissa more. Hagen's the name, by the way. And it's my honor to welcome you to Dirty Old Sun, the metropolis of opportunity. The opportunity to make something of yourself, or the opportunity to have a very messy death. Good luck to you. On the night of a thousand ribbons, our finest city burned. It burned with fires lit by cruelty and neglect. It burned with shame for giving the title of emperor to a man who did not deserve it. Thank you.
too much clutter.
You're right. Good luck, dear.
Thank you.
Tolman's dead then. Another victim of Piety's cruelty. Perhaps he escaped lightly. Look upon Grigor to see what life entails under Piety's influence. Let me offer you something. In recognition of all that you have done for us, we shall mourn. General Gravisius demands absolute obedience from his blackguards, meaning he's surrounded himself with cowards and lackwits, unable to lift a finger without orders. If you are able, traverse the river and murder Gravisius in his own barracks. You'll be ripping the very mind. Well.